First-person shooters are awesome. They're action-packed games backed by incredible graphics. And if I wanted to quickly make an FPS, there's some really great options. You've got easy tutorials in Unreal Engine, and Unity even comes with a fully featured FPS sample that works right out of the box. But what if you wanted to build one using something else? Weirdly enough, anything JavaScript-related isn't really that high, or even present, on the list of engines that you might use. I feel like I can make it work though. First-person camera systems are conceptually pretty simple. You've just got the camera wedged in the guy's or the girl's chest, and every movement happens relative to your orientation. I started by working on getting simple camera movement working first. It doesn't take much to get a simple scene with simple camera movement going. The devil's in the details though. You can play around quite a bit with getting little details in. Like that head bobbing effect, it's just a sine wave that you apply to the camera as you move. Although one little detail of that is that you ideally want to stop at the end of a step, otherwise you stop higher or lower, like we've done here. So a little bit of extra code to dig into these kind of details really helps. Once that's working, you may notice the problem. The problem is that we can just pass through walls. We have no collision detection whatsoever, so we'll be integrating some sort of physics engine. I've been using ammo.js in projects, which is actually the bullet physics engine, a great little open source physics engine that's good enough for Red Dead Redemption, so it should be more than good enough for us too. This should have been easy, but in reality it wasn't. The docs suck, the examples suck, everything sucks, including me, I kinda suck at physics. Anyway, with enough trawling through forums and Stack Overflow, I was able to cobble together a working BT kinematic character controller snippet of code, and the end result was that I can run around. I can't pass through walls anymore, but I can slide along them at angles though. I can do all the things that you'd expect, including jump. Look, I can jump. That came along as a nice little bonus. Let's add some guns now. I grabbed this gun off of Sketchfab. It looked pretty cool, so I'm happy. There's not much to making it look first-person shootery, just gotta offset it right until it's roughly where we want it relative to the camera. After that, shooting is up next. And the trick here is to use ammo.js's raycasting abilities to cast a ray out from our gun barrel and see what it hits. So whenever I press the mouse button, we fire off a raycast query and figure out if we hit anything, and then react appropriately depending on what you hit. I'm not a violent guy though, so we'll make this a paintball gun instead of a killing people gun. So to get that splat effect, we could use textures, but I'm going to hijack 3.js's shaders to do this procedurally for more variation. We also use 3.js's decal system to procedurally create decals from the underlying geometry. Now when I fire off a shot, look at that, we do a little splat on the wall and we get our paintball effect. The cool thing about this is that it rounds corners nicely and you get a different pattern each time you fire a shot. Easing functions are an awesome little tool to have in your toolbox as a programmer, because you can use them to procedurally add animations to shaders or meshes like magic. I added an exponential impulse to blend between two rotation quaternions, and the end result is a little firing recoil when you take a shot. You can of course play with it. Maybe recoil more like a machine gun instead of a pistol, up to you. The next step is that I wanted to add some UI. I took Doom Eternal as my inspiration and figured I could pretty much copy their layout. The nice thing about using JavaScript is that I can do this all in HTML and CSS, if you want to call that a nice thing. So I threw some styled elements onto the screen with 3D transforms and box shadows and sourced a bunch of icons from Google's free library. So we have our health and charge bars down here. I give this guy a charge up power to run super fast. Ticks down the bar by just adjusting the width and changing the color. On the right, here's some more UI. I kind of drew this in GIMP, but the rest of it is icons and text. At the top, I'm actually not quite sure what this does in Doom, so I put some random icons up here. I worked on adding enemies next. I grabbed this little robot thing from Quaternius. Comes fully animated already, I just plopped him into the world, but he doesn't do anything right now. We can fix that by adding some crude AI. If we give him his own collision detection, like we have for ourselves, and then throw together a quick finite state machine that has him in idle, walk, and shooting behaviors, we can really quickly and easily give him a bit of personality. See, now he sees me and walks towards me and even tries to impotently shoot at me. Too bad only I have the gun. So yeah, of course, next thing is, you give him a gun. And I also coded up this force field thing using some Voronoi noise. Now he's trying to take shots at me, and he has this cool little force field around him. And if I take a step back here and fire off a few shots at him, his shield kind of changes color, and eventually he dies, and I added this quick dissolve away effect. Pretty happy how easy that was. Let's make this look better now. Let's make a quick level. So what I'll do here is I'll quickly place down some cubes and planes and stuff, kind of randomly. We'll also place a few models that I grabbed off of Sketchfab that looked pretty cool. That looks kind of neat. We've got floating islands and different levels now, and I can run around and jump and play and do whatever I want. From the corners, though, you can see that this doesn't look as good as it could. It's really apparent the shadows suck. They don't extend out very far, and we don't get that nice shadowing on the distant blocks. Cascading shadow maps is typically the answer to these kind of large landscapes, and as luck would have it, there are options in 3.js that I was able to integrate. Now we peek out from the corner of the map here, it looks great, and we have shadows going on. If you look in the distance, you've got shadows, but you've also got shadows nearby, and both of them have enough detail. I can also inject some of my own shader code into 3.js for these cubes, add some triplanar mapping and noise. That saves me from actually modeling a level. And that gets me this kind of neat, futuristic look. I like it. I also want to get some bloom in here, but 3.js doesn't quite do what I want. So I copy-pasted theirs and I'm rewriting it slightly to be driven by the alpha channel. That way, I can selectively bloom those light-emitting squares, and even my shots have a kind of glow to them, but nothing else does. I also played with the sky a bit. What I did was I combined a cube map of the sky with a cube map of stars. Then I drove the mix between those using the sky's luminance and applied some color grading. There's also a bit of rotation using time, and I added that for that small bit of movement to keep it from being totally static. I also bloom out the sun manually via the shader, so you get a sort of bleed-over effect in that direction. This also means that those force fields on the droids, they glow a bit now, which improves the look quite a bit. I also took the opportunity to add a little radial blur effect, as a simple fall-off from the center with a bit of basic color manipulation. And here it is in action. When activated, I contrast the center and desaturate a bit towards the sides. I don't know. See what works for you. There's also a subtle vignette around the edges of the screen because I like the look. Anyway, that's about as far as I feel like taking this. It works. I've got the beginnings of something here. Maybe somebody wants to actually take this and turn it into a real game. So the code will be available on GitHub. Look for an announcement on Twitter for when it's available. Until next time. Cheers.